This week, I'm going to show you how to stack your astrophotography images. As there's not much light about at night, you really have to bump up your ISO, so this means an increased noise pattern in your images. So in stacking the shots and taking things called dark frames, you can really reduce this noise. I am going to be using Lightroom and Photoshop in this tutorial. So if you don't have these, click on the link in the description and this will take you to a free trial. Also, there is a link in the description to the raw files that I used in this tutorial. If you don't have access to dark skies, this will still give you the opportunity to stack these images together. I've also included two edited images, one from stacking and one from a single image, so you can see the difference for yourselves. In this video, I'm only going to use Starry Landscape Stacker, but if you have a PC, you can download the free software Sequiter. I've left a link in the description to both of these programs. You can stack them in Photoshop and you can move the images around to get them lined up, but it is a long, tedious, drawn-out process. If you're not sure how to shoot the stars but want to learn more, click on the eye in the corner or the link in the description to my astrophotography tutorial. I do use the A7 III in it, but no matter what camera you use, you can follow along and just copy the settings into your own camera system. Basically, you need to take a sequence of photographs and then stack them in the computer afterwards. Your camera needs to be perfectly still between images so it can actually blend them together. In the sequence, I shot 20 images of the night sky and then I did 10 dark frames. Dark frames are basically a way to get an image of just the noise your camera produces for the night and those conditions. All you do is basically keep the camera on the same settings, put the lens cap on, and take another series of frames. You can either shoot these separately by pressing the shutter button after each shot is completed, or use the new interval function if you have the A7 III or the A7 R3. To do this, go to tab 1, 4 of 14, and select interval shoot function. Turn interval shoot on, set the number of shots to 20. As you're shooting at night, you should be in manual mode, which blanks out shoot interval priority. If not, this should be off, so the exposure time overrides the interval time. This will then give you minimal gaps between shots. Once you get a good composition, your focus is correct and your settings are good, press the shutter button and wait for the camera to take the sequence. Once done, change the number of shots to 10. Put the lens cap on and take these 10 dark frames with exactly the same settings as the 20 light frames. The only difference is you've got the lens cap on, so you're not going to get any data of the sky. This is just to record the noise pattern of your camera on that night for the given conditions. Then it's time to process your images. Once you've imported your photographs into Lightroom, you need to make a few changes before exporting TIFF files for Starry Landscape Stacker. Also, it's good to create a mask for the foreground, so I'll show you how to do that as well. If you do have any abnormal frames in the sequence, like if there's a road going through the shot and there are light streaks and the frames are different, this is what can mess up the stacking process. So basically make sure there's no light streaks from cars in the shots. Airplane trails are okay, as well as small shooting stars. So once in Lightroom, I'll select the first image and then set my white balance. I underexpose my shots as I have an ISO invariant camera, but if you shoot with a Canon or one with a variant sensor, you'll have to get a good image in camera. I'll then push my contrast all the way down. I'll bring the blacks up a little bit. Going down to details, I'll remove all the sharpening and noise reduction. And then in lens corrections, I'll remove chromatic aberrations. Then switch it to manual and remove any vignetting that your lens is producing. In this sequence, I use the 12mm Lauer and there's quite a bit of vignetting. I always find that looking at the thumbnail in the top left-hand corner helps me see the overall vignetting. Once I've made all these changes, it's time to sync all of the shots. So select them all, including the dark frames, and sync all. When exporting the images, select the file type as TIFF, sRGB, and a 16-bit. I don't put any compression on it, I don't resize, and I'll retain all the metadata. I'll then save them all to one folder, including the dark frames. Next, it's time to create a mask. You can manually do this in Starry Landscape Stacker, but I prefer to do it in Photoshop for a more accurate mask. To do this, right-click on one of the images and then open it up in Photoshop. Once opened, click on Select, and then Select and Mask. Once in this Select and Mask, start painting out the sky. If it paints out everything, you might have to paint back in the land or foreground. You can do this by holding down Option and painting it back out. If you have any trees or details along the horizon, click the Refine tool and paint these out. If you're having trouble doing it this way, you may have to invert your mask. But there are plenty of tutorials on this on YouTube. I've linked one to the eye in the corner and I've put a link in the description. Then click View and select Overlay. This will show you in red what will be masked out. I then use Global Refinements to clean up the mask. I'll normally add a bit of contrast and then a little bit of feathering. After that, click OK. Then select the mask, select All, select Copy, select New, set Grayscale 8-bit and create a new image. Then paste the mask in, hide the bottom layer, and then save as a TIFF file without layers. Name it Mask, and in the same folder you've exported your images to. Next, open Starry Landscape Stacker, and then import all images. It should automatically add the mask and know which ones are the dark frames and which ones are the light frames. The light frames are basically the images that you've taken of the night sky. If you have a high megapixel camera, it'll take a while as these TIFF files are really big. Then enter your focal length. You can ignore Find Sky as you've already created a mask. If you skipped creating your own mask, this would be the time to do it. And you use these tools as a normal masking tool system. If you didn't create a mask in Photoshop, this is what you'll see when you import your images. It should pick up most of the stars with these red dots. If there are any red dots on the foreground, you need to get rid of these. Just make sure you've selected Erase Red Dots and then rub them out. Once you've done this, click Find Sky. It will then attempt to build a mask. So you can see now why creating a mask in Photoshop is so much better. Now all you need to do is paint the rest of the sky in. Just make sure the sky is selected and paint up to the horizon. If you do paint over the horizon, click on Ground and then rub that bit back out. With this example, it's pretty straightforward as the horizon is quite flat. But say if you've got trees protruding up from the horizon, it'll be a little bit more tricky. I'm going to roughly paint this in, but you can be as precise as you want. As I said before, this is why I prefer creating my masks in Photoshop and then importing them into Starry Landscape Stacker. Once it looks okay, click Align With. This will give you a preview. If you don't like how the Milky Way looks in the sky, you can change the current image. But I like it where it is, so I'll click Align and Composite. It will then process the final image. At this point, you can choose to save just the image, or the image and a mask of the sky. If you don't need a separate mask of the sky, uncheck this box. Then click Save. Name the stacked image, and then the mask if you have selected that option. Once saved, bring the image into Lightroom and edit as normal. If you want to learn more about editing in Lightroom, click on the eye in the corner to another of my tutorials. So I've edited two shots. One stacked and one single image. You can see that the sky is a lot clearer in the stacked one and the foreground is so much less noisy. I was actually really surprised at how much cleaner the foreground was. I thought it would blend and get rid of noise in the stars, but I wasn't sure how well it would do on the foreground. So this is really good. You can see that the single image has a lot of noise, including long exposure noise. Whereas the stacked image doesn't have this. I probably should have shortened my exposure time as the stars are starting to streak. But when zoomed out, they look fine. And that's about it. If you want to reduce noise in your astrophotography shots, Starry Landscape Stacker or stacking your images in a program like Sequiter is a really viable option. After doing this test, I think I'm going to start stacking my shots more and more. I've shot around about 10 years of astrophotography shots, and I've always taken single images. I've almost seen it as a bit of a challenge to try and get the shot in one image. But after doing this test, I think I'm going to start stacking more. As always, if you like what you see, give me a thumbs up. If you didn't, give me a thumbs down. And for weekly tutorials, hints and tips in photography and videography, subscribe and turn on notifications. I'll see you in the next one.